Yes, interestingly, because they're already talking about inflation, that this can actually contribute to U.S. inflation if this drags on. And now, Aladdin, can you give us a sense of just how important this is? Although you already mentioned a bit about how the bridge and the waterway has been critical in terms of trade, in terms of shipping. Can you give us a sense of how this might affect the economy from your standpoint?
Jobs. There is about 15,000 jobs that's connected to the port itself and about 140,000 jobs indirectly. So that is huge in itself. On top of the fact that, again, you know, there could be some supply chain delays, knowing how important the port is in the East Coast. There are talks of rerouting them to other ports, but other ports already are almost in capacity as well when it comes to receiving shipments and ships. So it will take a while to really, really, you know, ascertain the impact of such loss of activity in our ports. On top of that, of course, the cost of rebuilding is going to be also substantial. Also, the federal government have said they're going to help us, but knowing how bureaucracy works here, it can also, of course, safety is paramount. So you can just imagine before they're going to allow ships to cross back again within this port, they have to make sure that the debris is totally gone. It's also not a very deep water. The water level is about 50 feet deep, which is just enough for the ships to cross that waterway, because it's a very narrow waterway. As I said, it's a river. It's called the Patapsco River. So having the debris there will also will obviously affect the ability of the ships to get in. It has to be removed completely for economic activity to resume. So it's really a big inconvenience. I have to mention that it's also a big hub for Filipino workers because the port employs a lot of Filipinos. And in fact, if you go to a Filipino store on a weekend here, you're most likely going to meet someone who is working from one of the ships getting their Filipino supplies in a Filipino food market. So so that alone is also a big, not only to the Baltimore economy or the Maryland economy overall, but also to Filipinos who have sort of found jobs in the shipping business and the cruise line business.
All right, Aladdin, based on what you're saying, it seems like a long shot, but we do hope that things normalize as soon as possible for you. Again, thanks a lot for coming to the show and talking to us. Stay safe.
Thank you, Stanley. Great seeing you.
All right.